Man, oh man, let me tell you, there are a lot of lazy people online nowadays. People that, you know, they ask a bunch of questions and they don't want to take the time to do any searching themselves. But the good news is that you could actually make some pretty easy money off of these people if you're willing to, of course, actually put in the work and, you know, actually find the answers that people are looking for. So, welcome back to another video on my channel. This is Ari once again with a brand new video, and in today's video, I want to go over how to make up to $25 per hour simply by searching Google. So, this is going to be pretty easy money considering that you're willing to do the work on like a lot of people online. But before we really dive into things, if this is the first time that you're on my channel, I'm always putting out new videos on a regular basis, Monday through Friday, about how to make money online, how to work from home in different ways, and how you can, of course, you know, generate some income online. So if you enjoy videos like that, definitely be sure to hit the subscribe button right down below this video, and this way you'll be notified whenever I post a brand new video on this channel. But without further ado, let's get into how you could, of course, make some easy money doing this. All right, so I'll reveal the name of the website in a bit, but this is pretty much what it looks like. So what you could do is, you know, this is a site that people, of course, come to and they ask questions. So it's pretty much any question that you could think of. Like if I, you know, scroll down here, we'll find questions like, okay, how much time does the average person spend browsing Netflix before watching? And you could, of course, you know, view that right there. You know, view like an answer someone gave. I need information on college university debt and costs in the US and how that has changed in the last 25 or so years. How much alcohol has consumed each night worldwide? Please provide demographic statistics for residents in a 3 mile radius of the Brooklyn Navy Yard. So these are questions that people are, of course, asked, you know, online on this platform right here, and they actually pay, of course, get an answer. Now, here's the thing. Here's a shocking thing. These people who are asking these questions here, they could literally just go into Google and they could search up any of these questions that they have, and they could easily find the answer just like that. And because, you know, they just go on this platform and they, you know, they pay to, you know, ask this question, it's pretty much like they're, you know, spending money on, you know, what they could easily find for like, you know, like a minute or so search. So what you could do is you could take one of these questions that, you know, someone of course asks, and you just you copy this, you highlight the whole thing, press Control C on your keyboard or Command C if you're on a Mac computer, and all you have to do is come up, you know, open up a new tab, and then you just search this right into Google. So, you know, I paste this right in here. How much time does the average person spend on Netflix before browsing? And literally right here is the answer. So what you would have to do is you want to, you know, look through different, you know, resources here, gather some information, and then you want to create a Google Doc where you pretty much put together the information yourself, and then you submit it to the person asking the question. Then once you do that, then you get paid the amount right there. So you could earn around, on average with this, around, I want to say, 20 to 25 bucks per hour. So it's pretty easy money that you are, of course, getting on this platform right here. But yes, yeah, so like this is the question right here. Netflix reports that it's 117 million users watch 140 million hours of content on average per day. So Streaming Observer editor-in-chief Chris Brander divided the number of hours by the number of subscribers to find that the average user spends 1 hour and 11 minutes each day watching Netflix. So, I mean, that pretty much goes over, you know, how much time people, of course, spend on Netflix. But, you know, of course, you could, you know, look through a few of these different resources right here, and then you pretty much just have to gather some information yourself. You know, you just do a bit of searching, you find the answer, and then you just submit it to the person asking the question. So that's pretty much all, you know, really all there is to it, and it's pretty much how it works. So the name of the website is called askwonder.com. That's the name of the website right up here. And pretty much this is the site that you could, of course, come to. And as you can see here, this is, of course, what it looks like. So how it works is, you know, you let them know what you're looking, what you're working on, and within minutes, we'll scale up a research team to get at the heart of what you're looking for. So that's the reason why people come to this platform. They have a question on their mind, they submit it to askwonder.com, and then a researcher can, of course, choose to, which would, you know, in this case, it would be yourself. You could then provide the answer to them there. So the benefit is, you know, fast turnaround, unlimited scale, hassle-free. And this company has worked with a ton of different, you know, brands, and you may be, you know, familiar with some of these. So like, you know, Bloomberg Beta, City Ventures, AARP, Knotel, Aspen Dental. So, a lot of big brands that they, of course, work with. And all you have to do to get started with AskWonder.com is you just have to go up to the top of the website, and you want to click on this button that says Try Wonder Now. It'll give you two options. You could either ask Wonder a question if you want to know the answer to something, which, I mean, if you want to know the answer to anything, go on Google, find the answer yourself. It really only takes, 5 minutes or so. Find whatever answer you're looking for. Or if you are not lazy and you want to help people by, providing them with an answer, you want to click on this option that says Become a Researcher. And it'll take you to this page right here, if it wants to load up, where you could, of course, get signed up with AskWonder.com. So earn money using your brain, work when you want, learn, expand your resume and your mind. And if I scroll down here, I mean, really all you have to do is you just enter some basic information, first name, last name, email, create a password, and then you just select the city you live in. And from there, you just click on I'm not a robot, and then you could just agree to terms, and then you could start the application. So from there, you could pretty much go through the process of getting signed up, and then once you get in the platform, then you could start answering questions and getting paid to do that. And if I scroll down a bit more, it'll give more information on, what it's all about. So like, popular research requests, recommended products or service, explain a trend or phenomenon, gather statistics, and determine the size of a market. So this is like the step-by-step process on how it works. So visit the research dashboard when you are ready to start working. So the benefit is that with this one, you could pretty much work on your own terms. So you pretty much go to their dashboard whenever you want to work. Step two is they assign you a request to work on. Step three is find answers and sources and synthesize your findings. And then step four is submit your work and celebrate. So pretty cool there. And then, you could just apply right here and then you get accepted. And then you could start researching. Now, the question is exactly how do you get paid out with this platform right here? So AskWonder, they pay primarily through PayPal. Sorry, I'm getting these notifications here. Turn off all notifications. Go away. The way that this platform, of course, pays out is through PayPal. So you want to have a PayPal account. If you don't have that, then you'll want to go ahead and create one. And it's pretty easy to, of course, set up. You just go to paypal.com, create a free account, and then you can get started working on this program right here. So that's pretty much all there is to it. That's really what AskWonder is all about. And I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. Let me know if you are excited to try this out for yourself. If you found it helpful, also be sure to give it a thumbs up because it really does help the channel. And if you want to learn more about how to create more of a passive income online, like I'd say the only downside to this site right here is that you are still at the end of the day trading your time for money, which means that in order to be making money on this program, or on this platform rather, is you have to be actually putting in work consistently. And if you are not, putting in work, then you aren't exactly getting paid. So if you are, stepping away from the computer, then that is time that you are not getting paid for. So that's kind of the only downside with this platform right here. So if you want to learn more about how to create more of a passive income, where you want to learn how to be your own boss, you want to be able to work on your own terms anywhere, wherever and whenever you want to, as long as you have an internet connection, then my number one first link down below this video will give you access to a free training that will show you how you can make more of a passive income online so that you can be your own boss, you can work on your own terms, wherever and whenever you want, and you could pretty much set your own schedule. So that's really what I recommend going for in the long term, is really by building up a form of passive income. So that this way, you can be your own boss. You don't have to, be constantly in front of the computer all the time, looking at all these different, online jobs. Because the problem is that a lot of them, they don't pay well, or even the ones that do, you end up having to, spend lots of time in front of your computer. And that's just really not the way that you, of course, want to go about it in the long term. So if you're going to be aiming to make money online in general, I really just cannot recommend enough is that focus on building up more of a passive income in the long term. So that's really what I wanted to go over in this video. I hope you found it helpful, and take care.